It's second down now. Here's Lance. That's going to be caught by Samuel. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Lance finding Debo there for the Niner first.
And this was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open. Just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space. And it worked awfully well. Got him not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch to pick up really nice yardage.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Now the number 8 rusher in the NFL last season, it's Elijah Mitchell. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down, second and right at a yard.
That was a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
Now a throw here to his running back, and he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48. Able to get the 1 yard he needed, but nothing more.
Well, that was a pretty favorable situation there. What would you call that, second and manageable? Smart play, too. Didn't force it downfield when he didn't have it. Just checked it down. Let him get the first down, and that's exactly what he did.
Two first downs have him up near midfield now on first and 10. And Lance now to throw. Over the middle, that's caught by McLeod. And the tackle going to be made at the 38.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
So from Panther territory now, it's first and 10 at the 38. To throw, it's Lance. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
I know at times people think we use it too often, but you've got to be able to throw guys open. And when you read zone, you've got to stick it in there before your receiver gets to the next guy in the zone. Otherwise, you bring him into the play.
And that's precisely what allowed that defense to disrupt the pass. An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. On second down, here's Mitchell. And he'll be brought down just outside of the 30. They get 7 out of that, so they're left with a 3rd and 3. Coming up here looking for 3 yards to pick up the first. They'll try and pick it up with Mitchell. And he's going to get the first down as they bring him down at the 23. The drive stays alive, a 3rd down gain of 8. If you make the stop there, maybe you hold him to 3 on this opening drive. They didn't get the stop.
Yeah, new set of downs now. Now you're worried about, just as you pointed out, not just giving up 3, possibly giving up 6. Let's see what they decide to do here because they've got to change up what they have been doing. It hasn't been working.
Throwing on first down is Lance. Completes it to the tight end, Kittle. And they've got it inside the 10 at the 8. That one goes for 16 yards. It sets them up 1st and goal.
A lot of precision being shown on this opening drive. They've been methodical. They've been crisp. And as a reward, they're going to be set up with an early 1st and goal.
They'll run with Mitchell. Trying to turn the corner, but he's going to be stopped right near the line of scrimmage. They'll say no gain on the play, and it'll be 2nd and goal. Looked like he was trying to bounce it outside, but no success.
Yeah, sometimes you got to just figure out where you're going to go, and sometimes you just have to take it to another spot. And trying to get it outside, the defensive pursuit was there and just ran him down.
Nothing on first down, so the ball remains at the 8-yard line, second and goal. The slot man in motion right. Another run, this time McCaffrey. And once again, he'll get possibly back to the line of scrimmage, but no more than that. No gain on the play there. They're going to need to come up with something better here on third and goal. Driven it down the field nicely here on the opening drive, but now it's put up or shut up.
No doubt about it, because to make that type of a drive and ultimately kick a field goal would feel very disappointing. But I'm just wondering, is the head coach thinking, is this four down territory? Might he go for it?
This has been a long drive. You got to figure a field goal would be a letdown. Can they convert now on third and goal? Touchdown! Christian McCaffrey, his sixth touchdown of the season. And the Niners get the upper hand as they're on the board first here this afternoon. Extra point splits the uprights, and that makes the score 7-0. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. Roberts electing not to try it, and this will come out to the 25. It'll be Sanders to begin the drive. And some space here. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. That's a good way to start the drive. 17 yards and a first down. Seemed like a couple sets of eyes were on the quarterback, so he decided, hey, I'm going to hand this off. Got a good gain out of it.
And you know you need good blocking up front in order to gain yardage, but every one of these RPOs, if you do it right and they look the same, whether it's handed off inside or the quarterback keeps it, that allows you to fool the defense so often. And in this case, fooled them with the inside run.
Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9. The Panthers at 1-3 here in the early part of the year. Now, they were losers last time out, trying to turn things around here in this one.
And it always helps to have a home crowd behind you, giving you encouragement as long as you give them something good to cheer about. So, you know, they just want to come out and play well for their faithful, and I expect them to do just that.
Steps away to his left. Throwing left side here, and it's complete. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. Rookie to rookie on the hookup there, and it's a first down.
And that's a nice throw right there. And I'll tell you what I've seen in recent times and actually watched a presentation in the offseason from a college offensive coordinator that showed about 10 different drills that he runs with his quarterbacks to show them how to get out of the pocket, how to get comfortable when they're doing so, and to make plays under that type of duress. That's an example of what we're seeing the colleges deliver to the NFL. They kept the receiver in the short field, but that let his quarterback get the ball quickly to him before either guy in double coverage could react.
Looking to throw again on 2nd down. Young. And some room to run now. And this will move the chains again as the tackle's going to be made at the 49ers 16. 22 yards on the catch and run, a first down.
That's the third time on this drive that these two have connected with each other. They've got a real rapport going. And right now, it's paying off with big chunks of yardage, as shown by that last play.
So the ball down to the 16 here for 1st and 10. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. To the end zone, but it's incomplete.
Oh, they were were so close, that close to their first points of the game. Just needed to hang on just a second longer, but he couldn't complete the process of the catch through the jostling from the defender.
Young's incompletion on first down leads to a second and 10. Out of the gun, here's the give to Hubbard. And he's able to get this inside the 10 down to the 9. They get 7 out of that, so they're left with a 3rd and 3.
That was a really nice run there to bring up 3rd and short. After the incompletion on first down, it's awfully nice to have a running back that you can hand it to and put you back in a good situation.
The 8th play of the drive coming up. It's 3rd and 3. Looking to throw, Young. And that is incomplete. Oh, he had a defender right there with him to force that to the ground. And 4th down now coming up.
That sure looked like a nice call by the defense, and they're very cohesive in their coverage. As soon as he cut inside, they broke on the football and met him as the ball got there and forced the incompletion.
This is up and good from Pinheiro. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So both teams come away with points on their opening drives. Now they still trail. They answered the touchdown with a field goal, but at least able to break that goose egg here early.
And that is what's important, right? Because they didn't let that initial touchdown go unanswered. Took the ball themselves, moved it downfield, and put it through the post for 3 points. Game on.
The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. The offense coming back out here. Plenty of energy, ready to roll, looking to just add to what they have been doing after scoring a touchdown, Charles, their last time out.
And that's a great feeling to have on the sideline, partner, knowing you just won the battle against the opposing defense. And since they came off the field, I'll guarantee you all they want to do is get back out there because they know they have the upper hand on that defense right now.
Took just one play to move all the way to the 44 as they try again on first down. Throwing now is Lance. Throw right side is going to be caught by Samuel. He's got room at the 30. A big play there for the Niners. And even 50 yards. Well, make that now 2 completions for him on this drive. And these aren't ordinary completions. They're big ones.
Yeah, these are the types that make a secondary talk to each other and not in a good way. Oftentimes pointing fingers. Hey, who's got him? Someone cover him. That type of indecision can open up to even more big plays.
Now a chance to make that big play really hurt. It's 1st and goal just outside the 5. 1st down, here's Mitchell. And across the chalk, into the end zone, it's a 49er touchdown. Elijah Mitchell, his 7th rushing touchdown on the year. And they are able to add on to their advantage. Point after, right down the middle. And that pushes the lead up to 11. 14, set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And Roberts choosing not to bring this one out. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. They trail now 14-3, an 11-point deficit as they start things out with a 1st and 10. Young's throw here on target to Hurst. And they work this well upfield across the 45. A well-executed 22-yard gain.
Good job there of getting his tight end involved because he lines up on the right side of the formation, just works his way across the field. I really like how they were in sync on that one. He spotted the open gap in the zone, and his quarterback found him, and they get a 1st down.
And he'll be brought down right on the 50, a gain of 3.
Good reactions there defensively. That screen was a little slow in developing, and they shut that one down with little gain.
Young now from the 50, and this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
Looked like both sides were anticipating a quick throw there, and the defense was ready to jump in and deny it, and they did.
Facing a third and seven following the incompletion on second down. To the air once more, Young. Buying time to his left. Open here, Adam Thielen. Touchdown, Panthers. Adam Thielen, 50 yards. And the Panthers have got it back to within a score. Pinheiro's extra point up and good. And that makes it a 14-10 ball game. The lead cut to just four as they kick it away and turn things over to their D. And he'll just sit on this one as their drive will start at the 25. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. Well, this offense looks like they have a little extra pep in their step as they take the field here for drive number three, because remember, Charles, drives one and two both ended in the end zone.
Yeah, right now they've just got to be careful not to lean into overconfidence, because every drive has a life of its own. But I like the way that they've started, the way that they're going about doing things right now. They've got a chance for that third consecutive touchdown, and that would be a crushing blow to the defense.
So the opening play of the drive goes backwards. Now they'll come up on second and 12. Lance looking to throw it. Got a man right side, it's McCaffrey. And they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield. 22 yards there, a first down.
Yeah, big play there. And when you have a running back that you can use like a wide receiver, when he has that kind of versatility, you do as they did there. Get him out of the backfield and give those defensive backs something else to worry about.
First down, Lance. The tight end Kittle has it on the left side. It'll go as a gain of four, and that will bring up second down.
Oh, it's time to give a little credit there to the defense. They played that very well, because it was a drag route, and he ran a little shallower than normal as he worked straight across the field. He was hoping he'd get lost behind the defensive line, but once he made the catch, nowhere to turn upfield and gain any yardage.
Here's a throw to his running back. It's complete. And they're going to get this to about the 44-yard line.
And I like the idea here. Get the ball in his hands, even if it's in the passing game. Three catches a week ago, and he does a nice job here to pick up yardage.
On first and 10, here's Lance. Another grab here for the dynamic Christian McCaffrey. And they'll be stopped right at the 30. On a play that started back at the 15, they pick up 15.
So many times in my career, I've heard coaches talk about completions are one thing, but as long as we're there at the catch and we get guys on the ground, we can live with that. But if you're going to give up 10, 12, 15 yards after the catch, then your defense is going to be in a lot of trouble.
So first and 10 now from the 30. And he'll send the tight end in motion left. A shotgun handoff to Mitchell to about the 26 here. Give him 4 yards on the play, and that will lead us into the 2-minute warning.
Cut. 32.
to throw on second and six. Lance over the middle. That's complete to McCaffrey. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Panthers' 15-yard line. Give them 10 yards on that one, and that'll earn them a fresh set of downs. Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. That's caught. It's McCaffrey again. Touchdown, 49ers! Christian McCaffrey with his second touchdown here in this first half as his guys are able to extend their lead. Extra point right down the middle, and that makes it a 21-10 game. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. Roberts electing not to try it, and this will come out to the 25. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. They'll look to make some inroads here, trailing 21-10 as they come up on a first and 10. Now Young. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he's upended at the 33, following a good pickup of 8.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here. And if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up a score.
And to the 42-yard line here and brought down there. Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half.
A first and 10 here, and you know, if they could just get 3 out of this, something about whittling it to a one-score game at half that might provide a psychological boost.
Now here's Young. Throw left side on target to Thielen. Now another timeout called for by the offense as the clock stops here with 46 seconds remaining in the first half.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
To throw again on second down, Young. And that is incomplete, nearly intercepted. The free safety couldn't quite get his hands around it, and it brings up third down.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
Third and short yardage, Young. And he's got Hurst, his tight end. And this will move the chains again as the tackle's going to be made at the 49ers' 39. Now the Panthers going to signal for their third and final timeout as it'll come with 36 ticks to go in half number one. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. They'll throw again, Young. Complete to Sanders, and he's brought down here just outside of the 20. Oh, he fakes a spike, and this is caught. So he fakes the spike, and they get the touchdown. Hayden Hurst, as the first half is winding down, and the Panthers are able to cut into this lead in the final seconds of the first half. Pinheiro's extra point up and good. And it's now 21-17. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25.
49er offense set to get this drive underway. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
So we've reached halftime here in a four-point game. As we get you down the coast to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman and our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach! And we welcome you back now alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn getting set for quarter number three here. It's been a shootout so far. We'll see which defense can make the adjustments as we get back underway in the second half. And no run back here as the third quarter will commence with a touchback. Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. This offense, Charles, had a strong first half throwing the football, at least in terms of yardage, but that hasn't translated so far on the scoreboard as they begin the third quarter here, trailing and looking for a little momentum.
Yeah, you're right about that because, you know, let's face it, in the first half, most of their focus was in the passing game, and to their credit, resulted in a healthy amount of yardage. So I would think that at halftime, they're going to anticipate that defense loosening up a little bit to try and cover the passing lanes. They've got to get the running game going, and there should be some gaps to run through now.
On second down, here's a run with Hubbard. And this is going to be a Panthers first down as he's got this up to the 40-yard line.
The Canadian track star put up over 600 yards as a rookie in Carolina, and that has earned him some major trust from the organization and his teammates, who both believe he can be an effective NFL starter.
On first and 10, it's Sanders. And he finds a little bit of room, enough for 4 yards. It'll be second down.
And that was a quality play to start a new set of downs. That was simply an offensive line winning the battle up front and winning in a big way and giving their guy in the backfield a nice lane to hit.
Following the pickup of 4, here's second and 6. They'll try to throw now. Young. Quick hitter here. It's complete. And they're going to get this up to midfield.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
On third and short, going with their tight end. And that gain of 9 buys them a new set of downs. And that looked like some pretty easy yardage there right up the gut.
And he's a guy that has some height to him. So when you don't have to drop a shoulder or create or get through contact or trash, makes it a lot easier to stay upright, see the field, and make a run as we just saw there.
First and 10, Young. Over the middle, it's complete. And they're going to get this down near the 35-yard line. I respect both sides on that play, CD. For him to be able to hold on to that football and the impressive tackle, wow.
Did you notice the look between the two of them as they came off the ground? That look did say the word respect.
It's a second down run with Sanders. And he's able to get it down to the 25-yard line. 41 yards rushing for him now, and he's carried the ball just 5 times. On first and 10, Young. And this one's incomplete.
Yeah, their back's up against the wall a little bit, and they come through by forcing an incompletion. Now they've got to continue to ratchet up the intensity a couple of more times and get off the field before giving up any more yardage.
Young's incompletion on first down leads to a second and 10. He'll drop to throw. That's caught over the middle by Hurst. And he's brought down, but not before a gain of 13, down to the 13. First and 10 in the red zone.
I love the drive they're working on here because they know they can take the lead with a touchdown. And so far on this drive, so good. They've moved the ball down the field with very little resistance defensively, but they better be prepared for some adjustments to come their way now.
From the red zone now, Young. And oh, that nearly their first pick of the game, but it falls down to the ground incomplete.
That certainly appeared to be a play call where they were just trying to make second down, second and short. I think they thought the coverage was off a little bit more than it was. Nice job there pressing up on it and forcing the incompletion.
Third quarter of a tight football game as we come up on a second and 10. Throwing, Young. And he's got it. Touchdown, Panthers. From 13 yards out. And the Panthers have taken the lead as they go right down the field and score on the opening drive of the second half. Pinheiro's extra point up and good. And that gives him a three-point lead. The kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And a decent return out to the 27-yard line. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. And, Charles, it feels like we're set up for a good second half here. Came out of the locker room, one-score game. Now the lead has already changed hands. Well, this offense, they've got an opportunity right now to take that lead right back.
Yeah, and it feels like you're going back and forth almost a little bit like a tennis match, right? And we're just, you know, our heads just keep moving. Which side has it? Which side's going to score? How are they going to go out doing it? A little bit of a challenge for each side trying to match each other.
Lance with a tap forward on the jet sweep. A nice play design there with the touch pass. Looked good at the start, but bottom line, the defense was ready.
And they did a nice job scouting, didn't they? Not just scouting, but now executing once they saw the play for real after having worked on it all week in practice. They drilled on the play, then they drilled him.
And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. Six DBs in the game. Here's Lance to throw it. Able to complete this one to McCloud. And he's going to have a Niners first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
I'll tell you what, a lot of those mid-range throws have been available because sometimes teams get too concerned about the deep ball and they leave too much space in front of them. And these guys have been taking advantage so far.
Lance now on first down. Sliding out of the pocket. And he can't find anywhere to go with it. And he goes down. Brian Burns flying in there and dropping it for the sack.
Now that was a passer's nightmare. The front door totally shut down by the defense, so he kept going backwards, hoping to find another avenue of escape. It didn't exist.
After the sack on first down, Lance. Leaping, and he makes the grab. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. That one good for 26 and a first down. Now Lance. He's going to drop this down to McCaffrey. And they're going to work this down to about the 32-yard line.
But they certainly had success throughout this contest getting him the ball in the passing game. And there he picks up another first down. Whatever they saw going into this one, they've been able to capitalize on it. And no adjustment has been made to take it away.
From the 32 now, here's first and 10. Shotgun now for Lance. Complete to the tight end, Kittle, over the middle of the field. And he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line. A good pickup there, a 22. And they won't be able to run another play. Time has expired on this third quarter. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. Come on. So not quite a first and goal. It's first and 10 from the 10. They run over center with Mitchell. And he'll get about four there as he takes it from the 10 down to the 6.
No, that wasn't an explosive run. That wasn't one that took it all the way to the house. But, boy, for a team that's had trouble running it the entire game, that's the kind of run they need, hopefully, to get themselves kick-started.
The run got four. Now they deal with a 2nd and 6. Right back to Mitchell here. And he gets halfway there from the 6 to the 3 on a gain of 3. Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
This offense on third down today, a perfect 3 for 3 as they look to keep that streak going. Here it's 3rd and 3. And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, San Francisco. Christian McCaffrey, his 3rd touchdown of the game, his 8th on the year. And the 49ers answer back with a touchdown of their own to take a 4th-quarter lead. The point after is good, and that will make this a 4-point game. The 49ers ready to kick it away, and here we go. And Roberts choosing not to bring this one out. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. We certainly have a good one on our hands. They're trailing after that last touchdown, but now a chance for this offense to try to snag that lead right back here in the 4th quarter. Maurice Hurst forced his way through, drops him for a loss of 10 yards.
That sack doesn't change their offensive game plan. They always want to air it out and try and get the ball downfield quickly. They're going to have to block a little bit better, though, because the urgency and pressure just increase. Twice the distance now just to get a first down, and one less down to try and get it.
Throwing on 2nd and long. Young. Throwing left side, it's complete. They'll wind up getting 7 on the play, and that'll make it 3rd and 13. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
Now on 3rd and long, they'll look to throw. Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Talanoa Hufanga. And the Niners are going to take possession of the football. 3rd and long that time. He was trying to make something happen, but a little too risky.
Well, the field tilted on him. And what I mean by that is what you said. 3rd and long, got to push it downfield to try and pick up the first down. Defensive backs live for this situation. And they took advantage of the young man right there.
From the 34 now, here's 1st and 10. Lance going to throw. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's 2nd down.
This is certainly a team that has proven it likes to target its backs through the air, and defensively, they were aware of that and certainly were prepared on that throw.
Off of play action, here's Lance. Over the middle to Kittle, complete. And he'll be brought down at about the 23-yard line. What a difference a week makes. 5 interceptions in their last game. Here we are, 4th quarter. He's played mistake-free football.
And I'm sure that we can look back on the past week and say, okay, spent time in the film room, and they worked on his mechanics. Sometimes it's just your team believing in you, your coaching staff believing in you, and you relax and play to your potential. He's doing that in this game.
And they're going to stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. Second and 10. Run blitz there defensively, something we might see more of here in the fourth quarter.
I think we'll see a lot of it, and the difference between that and a pass blitz, you're just trying to get to the quarterback. You're trying to scheme someone open who will get to the QB and make sure he gets on the ground. In a run blitz, you're actually trying to cover up gaps, trying to cover up holes so they can't run the football.
Lance's throw complete there to McLeod. And they're going to get this down to about the 17-yard line here. In search of 4 yards here to pick up the first down. That flag accepted, and it backs the offense up a little bit. Instead of a 3rd and 4, now they have to manage a 3rd and 9 after the delay of game. Here's Lance. Open man is IU complete. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7. They're able to convert on 3rd down, and that sets up a 1st and goal.
And that certainly appears to be a critical conversion right there, because not only do they keep the drive going, they take valuable time off the clock as well. They have to feel really good about that last completion.
And he's brought down right at the 5-yard line. Give him 2 on the play. Able to stay in bounds, so the clock keeps rolling. This defense right now backed up in the red zone. Another touchdown, it's over. They've got to stand tall quickly.
Been in this spot before. Now there's a little bit of desperation creeping in. And all you're doing when you're talking to your defensive teammates is, first guy there, hold him up. Second, third guy in, rake it the football. Get it out. We've got to create a turnover, because one more score, and this game's over.
Here we go. And the ball smacked down on the 5-yard line. Here's 2nd and goal. Up the middle, here's Mitchell. And across the chalk, into the end zone, it's a 49er touchdown. Elijah Mitchell with his 2nd touchdown of the game, number 8 on the season. And the 49ers look like they're going to get back in the win column as they extend their lead here in this fourth quarter. Extra point splits the uprights, and that pushes the lead up to 11. The 49ers ready to kick it away, and here we go. Roberts electing not to try it, and this will come out to the 25. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And the script really is flipped for them. The momentum on the other sideline, and now they have to try and battle back from a 2-score deficit. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. That'll be caught by his tight end, Ian Thomas. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. Nice way to start the drive, a gain of 12 and a 1st down. A good start there on 1st down. They've got to have this drive.
No doubt about it. Down a couple of scores. They have to find a way to put it in the end zone. Chunk plays, explosive plays. That will be the key to this drive.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on 1st and 10. Young to throw it. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. And the 49ers are going to take possession of the football. That time defensively looked like they showed quite a bit of pressure, but backed off, and it proved fruitful. They get the pick.
He went through all of his rules about getting rid of the ball quickly because he read blitz. He saw all those people stacked at the line of scrimmage, and then they fooled him by dropping into coverage. Now he's ready to get rid of the ball fast, but guess what? Too many defenders out there. Exactly as you described, an interception.
And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20.
That good for 22 and a first down. This defense, Charles, they have unraveled here in the fourth.
In a sense, it's like they're being pressed like in a basketball game, and they just can't get the ball over half court. I mean, no matter what they do, they can't get off the field. They can't slow them down. They're just going up and down the field against them. Yeah, unraveling would be a perfect word for them.
Credited with a one-yard gain there to make it second and nine. 2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So second and nine, and you'd have to figure just about all 11 probably crashing the line here. Another run with Mitchell. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. It's a four-yard pickup there, and it leaves him with third and five. Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. They'll need five on this play to move the sticks. From the gun on third down, Lance. Got an open man. It's McLeod. Touchdown! Ray McLeod. A 12-yard touchdown grab. And the Niners have pretty well put it away here in the fourth quarter. He's got them out now to a three-score lead here in the fourth quarter after that one, CD. And well, he looked right off the line like he knew that that ball was coming his way, and he secured it for 6 points.
Yeah, and I think when you're leading by a healthy margin already, it actually loosens you up and allows you to take maybe a few more chances and definitely play with more confidence, because he certainly saw something he could exploit in the defense, and he made sure to let his quarterback know, just get it to me. And the rest was all up to him, and he delivered and made it a three-score game.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And Roberts choosing not to bring this one out. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. Well, this game, it has had no shortage of offense. They've been able to put up a decent amount of points on this side, Charles. They just have not been able to keep pace with the other offense they're going against here.
Yeah, that's a good way of pointing things out, because now it's not a total loss, because as you said, they've scored some points, so there's some plays they can build on, moments where the game plan actually worked. But overall, though, they were just out-personnel. They were going up against a team that's playing at an elite level.
Here's second and seven now from the 28. Another run with Sanders. And only able to get two here. Stopped at the 30. Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense that next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
Ready. 60 red. 60 red. Claude red. Let's
bring it. To throw, Young. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he is going to have a Panthers first down as he's able to get 8 yards there on third and five. Now a first down throw for Young. And that one drops down incomplete. Good coverage there. Forced the ball free, and it's second down. He did an okay job of absorbing the hit, just couldn't secure the football through the catch.
And he was right there on the spot and forced the incompletion. That's something defenders work on all the time. If you're there, make the contact, but continue to work your way through the receiver so that he can't possess the football and turn it into a catch.
Now a deep ball there on on second down, but it'll wind up incomplete.
That's coverage you'd expect to see in a tie game late. Not in a lopsided game like this. They are not letting up.
So back-to-back incompletions, and that has them staring at a third and 10. Young. And unable to connect. Incomplete. Give them credit. They took their shot, but it's going to bring up fourth down.
Even with such a big lead late, the effort hasn't lapsed one bit. If the offense wants to score some points in this one, they're going to have to earn it. These guys are not giving up anything. 53.
It's desperation time. Young on fourth down. And it's going to be batted down. It will go the other way with the football. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And the Niners take over in terrific field position. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. McCaffrey running up the middle. He'll work his way up the middle for a gain of about four, second down. Now the offense knew it. They were already starting to walk back as that one is accepted.
Come on, set, 33, yellow.
Get in the way, bro. Get in the way, slot man moves right. The gut, McCaffrey. And he'll take this for a short gain on what will prove to be the final play of this ball game. So the victory here for San Francisco, and we talk so much about the turnover battle, determining who wins, who loses. This game, no exception. Air-free football, no turnovers at all, and they win it.
So this is one you don't have to convince your team that what you're saying is accurate. And you know what I'm talking about. Head coach always stands up in front of the team and says, guys, if we do this, this, and this, we'll win. And usually they say, if we win the turnover battle, we'll win. Well, here's the proof right there. Win the turnover battle, go on to victory. Now the guys believe. You move on to the next lesson where you have to convince them. This one is now planted.
So for the 49ers, they move back over 500 at 3-2 now on the year. And they'll get another road test next week as they head to Atlanta to take on the Falcons. Meanwhile, for Carolina, they'll fall to 1-4 with a loss. And they'll look to regroup next week as they head to L.A. to take on the Rams. Thanks for tuning in, everybody. Alongside Charles Davis, we thank our entire crew. I'm Brandon Gauden. This is the NFL on EA Sports.
Deep in the streets, felt it, baby, the mental line. When they watch calls,